They got FEMA caskets. They're hiding them in the bushes. What is that telling you? They know a lot of people are going to die. Something is coming down. You can tell something is going on. Why? Obama's cabinet is abandoning ship. They're leaving him alone. Understand? When you see that kind of stuff, you know something is going to happen. Right? Because he's going to get all the blame. Understand? And we don't support him either. He's a stinking Hamite. He's a heathen according to the Bible. Understand? Just as in the Titanic, when the Titanic sank. Before it sank, the people who knew it was going to sink, what did they do? They abandoned the ship. They left the captain and they abandoned ship. Same thing happened with Rahm Emanuel leaving and all the other cabinet members who's leaving. They know something is going to happen. So what? They're leaving, they're abandoning ship. Understand? And Obama, the captain, he got to go down with the ship. Understand? Let's go to Matthew 24. I saw the FEMA caskets, man. With my own eyes, I saw them caskets. Understand? But they're hiding them in the bushes. That's saying a lot. A lot of y'all people are ignorant to that. A lot of y'all are ignorant to it. Understand? It's going to get that bad. Two parts of y'all are going to die. It's going to get so bad, the righteous shall scarcely make it. Let's go into Matthew 24 and 22. And except those days be shortened, there should no flesh be saved. But for the elect's sake, those days shall be shortened. All right, for the elect's sake, those days shall be shortened. Why? It's going to get that bad here. It's going to get that bad in America. Let's go to 2 Ezra 13. Ezra 13 and 23, because it's going to get real bad out here in these streets. Alright? 2 Ezra 13, 23. He that shall endure the perils in that time hath kept himself. They that be fallen into danger are such as have worked and have and faith towards the Almighty. Alright? We endure this stuff, man. We're the ones who have kept ourselves. All right? Let's go into 2 Peter. 2 Peter 1 and 10. Wherefore the rather, brethren, give diligence to make your calling and election sure. For if ye do these things, ye shall never fall. Alright? Give diligence to make our calling and election sure, that we might escape the perils that's coming upon America. Alright? Let's go to 1 Peter. 1 Peter 4 and 7. But the end of all things is at hand. Alright, the end of all things is at hand. The end of all things is at hand. Alright, this is the end of all things right here. It's at hand. And watch unto prayer. Alright, we're supposed to watch. Alright? Let's go to 2 Ezra 13. Second Ezra 13, verse 18. Now understand I the things that are laid upon Zilak. Zilak. Now understand I the things that are laid up in the last days. Alright? Now I know what's going to go down in the last days. The Most High said before he does anything, Amos 3 and 7, before he does anything, he revealed his secrets unto his servants. Alright? 2 Ezra 13 and 18. Now understand I the things that are laid up in the last days, which shall happen unto them, and to those that are left behind. All right? Let me read that again. 2 Ezra 13 and 18. Now understand I the things that are laid up in the latter days, which shall happen unto them, and to those that are left behind. They, therefore, are they come into great perils and many necessities, like as these dreams declare. All right? What are the perils? This is one of the perils. All right? This is one of the perils right here. This is one of the perils right here. The mark of the beast. All right? Mark of the beast. Let's get into that. Revelation, the 20th chapter. Revelations, as I said, this is one of the perils that's going to come upon here, right? This is one of the perils that's going to come up here. How we're going to be tried. Revelations 20 and 4. And I saw thrones, and they sat upon them, and judgment was given unto them. And I saw the souls of them that were beheaded for the witness of Yahweh Shai, the one you call Jesus, and for the word of the Most High, and which had not worshipped the beast, neither his image, neither had received his mark upon their foreheads or in their hands, all right? The ones who were beheaded because they wouldn't accept the mark of the beast. The ones who would never consider this as a means or a way out. Understand? Who were beheaded, all right? Which had not worshipped the beast, neither his image, neither had received his mark upon their foreheads or in their hands, and they lived and reigned with Hamashiach 1,000 years. All right, so we're going to live and reign with Hamashiach 1,000 years. 1,000 years, all right? Because why? We ain't going to accept the mark of the beast. We ain't going to do as the Romans do. We'll never do as the Romans do. We'll never bow to Baal, or whatever gods or whatever they set up here. Understand? We never sell out, man. Understand what I'm saying? We stand firm for this gospel. We stand firm for this gospel, man. Understand what I'm saying? So to all you Rothschilds, Rockefeller, DuPonts, Gettys, you international bankers, understand? Go ahead and do what you gotta do. Collapse the system, man. Collapse this already. What's taking y'all so long? Understand what I'm saying? We're ready, willing and ready for this thing to go down, man. All right? Get your martial law ready, man. What's taking y'all so long? Let's do this. All right?